Thank you for joining us for the 2022 Utah America Pageant. We'd like to remind you that no flash photography or videography will be allowed during the show. Thank you for your cooperation. Let's meet our Miss Utah for America Strong contestants. Let's meet our Mrs. Utah contestants.
I'm Karen Kahn, Mrs. Davis County.
Mrs. Brigham City, Jamie Hadfield. You look
like bad news. I got it.
Michelle Miles, Mrs. Lehigh.
Chelsea Roberts, you're Mrs. Cash Valley.
Mrs. Mapleton.
Mrs. Sandy City.
Soledad Schmatz, Salt Lake City. This place is too crowded.
Too many cool kids. Haley Lundberg, this is Southern Utah County. Seems like one of those
guys. We pitch the whole state. Faith Joy Soul, this is Salt Lake County.
Instead of sleeping in.
Alyssa Hagen, this is Summit County.
I'm Ashley Stratton, Mrs. Spanish Fork.
Clarissa Thomas, Mrs. Utah County.
Hi everyone, my name is Kimberly Modishard and I am Mrs. West Jordan.
Welcome to the 2022 Utah America Pageant. I'm your host, Nick Perez, also known as Sergeant Perez on X96. Tonight, we welcome 29 beautiful representatives vying for the Mrs. Utah America, the Mrs. Utah American, and the Ms. Utah for America Strong titles. Last year, three women represented Utah on the same national stage where Elvis Presley once performed. Tonight, they will each take their final walk. Ladies and gentlemen, escorted by this year's honorary Mr. Utah, Andrew, please welcome Mrs. Utah America 2021, Hannah Nealman, Mrs. Utah American 2021, Ann Forrester, and Ms. Utah for America 2021, Adrian Edwards. Thank you, ladies. We will talk more with you later. And thank you again, Mr. Utah. So are you ready for the swimsuit competition? Let's try it again. Are you ready for the swimsuit competition? All right. This year we are excited to announce a new partnership with our incredible swimsuit sponsor, Graham Swim. Not only is this company local and female-owned, it's also a business that celebrates every body. With size-inclusive models and styles that are designed for comfort and fit, Graham Swim is committed to helping women feel confident in their own skin, whether they're swimming, boating, or just having fun in the sun. Tonight, each of our contestants will be wearing a swimsuit from their 2022 collection. Be sure to visit them at grahamswim.com to find your perfect suit. Judges uses this swimsuit competition to evaluate each contestant's commitment to health and fitness. This portion of the competition counts for 25% of each contestant's total score. Let's get to know each of these ladies, beginning with our Ms. Utah for America Strong contestants. Ms. Eagle Mountain, Leandrina Hadlock. Leandrina is the owner of In Motion Dance. She has 5 children. When asked about her favorite quote, she said, "Fear can stand for, face everything and rise. My life has been filled with times when I felt afraid. With the right tools, hard things become doable. Challenges are an opportunity for learning and growth." Leandrina Hadlock, Ms. Eagle Mountain. Ms. Juab Twyla Simpson. Twyla is a student who loves to play instruments. She says, "Music is my life." When she is not studying or playing music, she loves to play sports and is very active in musicals and plays. Her favorite quote is, "Be strong when you are a wreck, brave when you are scared, and humble when you are victorious." Twyla Simpson, Miss Juab. Miss Lehigh, Natalie Castro. Natalie is an autism real estate specialist who helps families design their homes to impact their children's independence and development. When asked about her favorite quote, Natalie replied, "Life doesn't happen to you, it happens for you. We are faced with challenges and opportunities in our lives. It is up for us to decide which one we are willing to put our energy and focus on." Natalie Castro, Ms. Lehigh. Ms. Linden Tammy Lewis. Tammy is a business owner and mother of three children. Her hobbies include dancing, spending time with her children, reading, and volunteering. Her favorite quote is, "Why fit in when you're born to stand out?" from the great Dr. Seuss. The best advice she ever received was, "You can do hard things, never give up." Tammy Lewis, Ms. Linden. Ms. Price, Janice Peterson. Janice is a registered nurse and mom of eight children, who recently graduated with her bachelor's in nursing from Utah State University. She loves spending time with her children and is also known for her can-do attitude and persistence in overcoming obstacles. Her favorite quote is, "Live strong, there's always beauty within." Janice Peterson, Ms. Price. Ms. Salt Lake City, Amanda Holt. Amanda is a Zaya Active representative who enjoys dancing, exercising, and shopping. She especially enjoys volunteering with the IMC Hospital and the Foundation for Children and Youth with Diabetes, a cause that is dear to her heart. Her favorite quote is, "Life is not about waiting for the storm to pass. It's about learning to dance in the rain." Amanda Holt, Ms. Salt Lake City. Ms. Saratoga Springs, Rachel Mahoney. Rachel is a junior technical recruiter and has one human child, Capri, and two fur children, Lucy and Hades. She enjoys singing, dancing, and spending time with her family. Rachel's life philosophy can be summed up by this quote, "There's no need to be perfect to inspire others. Let others be inspired how you deal with your imperfections." Rachel Mahoney, Ms. Saratoga Springs. Ms. South Jordan, Ashley Condi. Ashley is a pharmacy manager. She enjoys running, weightlifting, playing soccer, traveling, and spending time with her beautiful daughter. The slogan for her company, Live, Love, Dream, Wellness, is to take charge, live, love, and dream large. That also happens to be her own personal philosophy on life as well. Ashley Condi, Ms. South Jordan. Let's bring back our Ms. Utah for America Strong contestants one more time for our judges. Thank you, ladies. And now, for our Mrs. Utah contestants, beginning with Mrs. American Fork, Brooklyn Wild. Brooklyn and her husband Jordan have been married for 8 years and have three children. She's a research assistant at Utah Valley University. Brooklyn says the best advice she's ever been given teaches that you can fail at what you don't want, so you might as well take a chance on doing what you love. Brooklyn Wild, Mrs. American Fork. Mrs. Brigham City, Jamie Hatfield. Jamie and her husband Jeff have been married for 16 years and have four children and an angel son. She and her husband co-own a car wash and a financial office. She says, "My grandpa said, leave it better than you found it." Whether helping teens stay off the drug path or buying a stranger's Diet Coke in the drive-thru, I try to leave everything better just like grandpa did. Jamie Hatfield, Mrs. Brigham City. Mrs. Cache Valley, Chelsea Roberts. Chelsea and her husband, Dr. Miles Roberts, have been married for 10 years and have two children. Chelsea studied at Weber State University, where she gained her confidence and valuable experience as a woman in corporate America. She enjoys teaching her daughters how to foster their creativity through painting, baking, and gardening. Chelsea Roberts, Mrs. Cache Valley. Mrs. Davis County, Karen Kahn. Karen and her husband, Chris, have been married for almost 10 years. She is a senior clinical project specialist who enjoys reading, getting creative in the kitchen, and volunteering in the community, especially at the local animal shelter. Her favorite quote is, "Remember that the happiest people are not those getting more, but those giving more." Karen Kahn, Mrs. David County. Mrs. Draper, Lauren Anderson. Lauren and her husband, Chris, have been married for 6 years and have 2 children. Lauren is the happiest when she's spending time with family and friends, boating on Lake Powell. She looks forward to weekly dates with her husband, kissing her baby's faces, and promises that if you love what you do, you'll never work a day in your life. Lauren Anderson, Mrs. Draper. Mrs. Harriman, Amanda Brady. Amanda and her husband, Ty, have been married for 21 years and have 5 children. Amanda is the founder of the Be the Good Challenge, a weekly social media challenge that encourages people to be the good they wish they see in the world. She's also the creator of Lido's Love, a project that has fed more than 2,000 first responders to date. Amanda Brady, Mrs. Harriman. Mrs. Lehigh, Michelle Miles. Michelle and her husband, Christopher, have been married for 25 years and have 7 children. She is a member of the Lehigh Historic Commission. Michelle is passionate about helping others identify and enhance their best features. Currently, she is working on bringing body image classes to young adults and teens in foster care. Michelle Miles, Mrs. Lehigh. Mrs. Mapleton, Kaylee Fawcett. Kaylee and her husband, Garrett, have been married for 14 years and have 4 children, all energetic boys. Kaylee is the creative of DG Homes, the residential renovation business she co-owns with her husband. She loves fiercely and believes bravely is the force that powers a meaningful life. Kaylee Fawcett, Mrs. Mapleton. Mrs. Rocky Mountain, Jessica Whalen. Jessica and her husband, Dr. Bo Whalen, have been married for 10 years. She is a flight attendant and fitness enthusiast who loves nutrition, working out, and taking dance classes. She is also the assistant director for the Salt Lake Senate dance team, part of the Salt Lake Senate Developmental Football League. She is a sports fanatic who loves to watch and play sports. She can make a half-court shot and kick a 33-yard field goal. Jessica Whalen, Mrs. Rocky Mountain. Mrs. Salt Lake City, Andrea Schmutz. Andrea Dane Soletta Schmutz has been married for 3.5 years to Dr. Christian Schmutz. They have 1 child. Andrea is an instructor for BYU Pathway, whose mom always reminded her of this quote, "Those who haven't tasted the bitterness of life's bitters will never appreciate the sweetest of life's sweets." She believes that you can never appreciate success unless you've worked hard for it. Andrea Schmutz, Mrs. Salt Lake City. Mrs. Salt Lake County, Faith Joy Sula. Faith is a children's book author and data center director of infrastructure. She and her husband, Matt, have been married for 1.5 years and have 5 children. Her favorite hobbies include running ultra marathons, singing, writing, and hanging out with her husband and kids. The best advice she's ever been given is, you can grin and bear it, or smile and change it. Faith Joy Solon, Mrs. Salt Lake County. Mrs. Sandy City, Heidi Peterson. Heidi and her husband, Mark, have been married for 12 years. She has 3 children, 2 stepchildren, 1 daughter-in-law, and 1 grandson. Her favorite quote is from Harriet Tubman, "Every great dream begins with the dreamer. Always remember you have within you the strength, the patience, and the passion to reach for the stars and change the world." Heidi Peterson, Mrs. Sandy City. Mrs. San Pete County, Jennifer Crozier. Jennifer and her husband, Blake, have been married for 19 years and have 3 children. Together, they co-own Crozier Construction Services. Jennifer stays strong by literally raising the roof. She breaks new ground with her shovel as she nails the build-up. She's not afraid of hard labor or being a constant work in progress. Jennifer Crozier, Mrs. San Pete County. Mrs. Saratoga Springs, Mandy Turner. Mandy and her husband, Clint, have been married for 19 years and have 3 teenage daughters. Mandy is a registered nurse who is passionate about helping teens. She recently collected and donated period products for the Utah Period Project, currently serves on the board of Wolfpack, a teen suicide prevention organization, and is involved with the motorcycle group known as Ride to Prevent Suicide. Mandy Turner, Mrs. Saratoga Springs. Mrs. South Jordan, Laura Forbush. Laura and her college sweetheart Jared have been married for 8 years and have 2 boys. She is the senior manager for an impact foundation, a mom, an author, a business owner, and manages a nonprofit foundation. She is also a Make-A-Wish grantor, helping to grant the life-changing wishes to children with critical illnesses. Laura Forbush, Mrs. South Jordan. Mrs. Southern Utah County, Haley Lundberg. Haley and her husband Josh have been married for 7 years and have 3 children. She is the owner of Bloom Terry Advanced Aesthetics. She loves sport fishing, especially in Alaska, and taking spontaneous trips across the country with her sisters. Haley's favorite quote is, "Almost isn't done," a phrase often used by her father when he would ask if her chores were done. Haley Lundberg, Mrs. Southern Utah County. Mrs. Spanish Fork, Ashley Stratton. Ashley and her husband Rob have been married for 11 years and have 4 children. Ashley trains women to achieve their goals without sacrificing what's most important. She plans to continue to help the women of Utah accomplish their dreams through her podcast series, powerful speeches, and retreats. Ashley Stratton, Mrs. Spanish Fork. Mrs. Summit County, Melissa Hagen. Melissa and her husband Aaron have been married for 32 years and have 3 daughters. Melissa is a flight attendant who enjoys family flying adventures and exploring Utah's natural wonders. She has been a powerful advocate for women and girls over 3 decades and wants to empower them to continue learning, leading, and lifting each other up. Melissa Hagen, Mrs. Summit County. Mrs. Utah County, Clarissa Thomas. Clarissa and her husband Dan have been married for 16 years and have 3 children. Clarissa is a behavioral change health coach and domestic engineer. Her motto is, "I'm going to make everything around me beautiful, and that will be my life." From healthy lifestyle design and behavior coaching to landscape design and home renovations, she embodies Aphrodite in the flesh. Clarissa Thomas, Mrs. Utah County. Mrs. Utah Valley, Micah Perry. Micah and her husband Justin have been married for 23 years and have 9 children. She enjoys running, hiking, floral design, and can redesign clothing with just a little imagination and a hot glue gun. She said, "When I look back at everything I've done in my life, my children are easily the best thing I've ever created." Micah Perry, Mrs. Utah Valley. Mrs. West Jordan, Kimberly Modishard. Kimberly and her husband Tyler have been married for 9 years and have 2 little girls. She is an avid cosplayer and costume designer, winning multiple titles in both the intermediate and master's division at FanX Comic-Con. After having a baby in December, she has devoted her life to healthy lifestyle through exercise, good eating habits. Kimberly Modishard, Mrs. West Jordan. Now let's bring our Mrs. Utah contestants back on the stage one more time. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, ladies. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the stage Hannah Nealman, Anne Forrester, and Adrian Edwards.
Yesterday, the contestants met with our prestigious panel of judges in a private interview. They evaluated their poise, intelligence, and conversational abilities. Each judge scores each contestant individually. While the personal interview counts for 50% of their score, the other 50% will be determined by tonight's performance. Let's meet the amazing individuals tasked with the unenviable job of choosing the next Mrs. Utah American, Mrs. Utah America, and Miss Utah for America Strong.
First are Mrs. Utah judges. Nikki Ames is a mother of 7 children, 6 boys and 1 girl. Nikki has been part of the dance community for 25 years. Nikki is the co-owner of Miss Drill Utah Pageant. Nikki is also the co-owner of Epic Productions Dance Camps and Conventions. She has over 20 years of judging experience in competitions, auditions, and pageants. Nikki enjoys the opportunity to motivate and speak to groups. She loves being involved in service projects and encourages everyone to get involved in their communities. Her favorite hobbies are planting flowers, attending concerts, and adventuring outdoors with her husband. Thank you, Nikki.
Sarah Christiansen is a wife, mom of 2, model, inspirational speaker, former Mrs. Nebraska America 2017, winning Mrs. Congeniality at Mrs. America, and director of Mrs. Nebraska America. She was a registered nurse for over 14 years before retiring to pursue other passions. When she is on social media, she loves empowering others with her unstoppable platform. When she was diagnosed with a severe cardiac arrhythmia, she was told she would never be able to have children, live an active lifestyle, and do many things most people take for granted. After 5 surgeries, including 2 pacemakers, she's proud to say she's turned every no into a yes, thanks to her grit and determination to be unstoppable. Thank you, Sarah Christiansen.
Matt Galland was born and raised in Provo, Utah, and has lived there most of his life. Spending 2 years in LA serving an LDS mission, he graduated from BYU and moved back to Davis, California to earn his MS and PhD in geography from UC Davis. After more than 10 years of teaching at Brigham Young University, he retired and became a full-time outdoor adventure photographer and world traveler. He has been married for 23 years and has 4 children. His hobbies include backcountry skiing, mountain biking, endurance trail running, and of course, flying jets and helicopters, which allow him to adventure around the world. Matt Galland.
Jeanette Lee holds 2 master's degrees in school administration and curriculum and instruction, and is a respected educator in Las Vegas. She was a finalist for the Heart of Education in Clark County School District in 2018 and 2019. Along with education, Jeanette is passionate about fashion, pageantry, and sharing awareness about the deaf community and the need for interpreters for the deaf. Respected for her wealth of knowledge and experience in pageantry and as a runway model, she has served as a competitor and a judge at local levels in state, local and national and international pageants. After winning the title Mrs. Utah America 2004, and with the backing and support of her sponsor, the Utah Jazz, Jeanette has been promoting her platform of deaf awareness on a national stage. Jeanette Lee.
Brian Swan is a seasoned business leader and established real estate professional here in Utah. As a real estate agent and a practicing attorney, he has a long and active career in the real estate profession, which includes residential and commercial real estate acquisitions, as well as holding executive positions within strong real estate-related companies. Through his business experience, he's successfully grown his own companies and been involved in a number of acquisitions. While still active in real estate, he now coaches and mentors business owners in growing and scaling their own businesses so that they can reach their own goals. In his off hours, he enjoys time with his family, the gym, and the downtime of quiet study. Brian Swan.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me now introduce you to our judges for the Miss Utah for America Strong. All right, originally from Arizona, Milo LeBaron moved to Utah in 2004 to study at BYU. There he met his now wife, Mandy. They have three children and live in Mapleton, Utah. During the recession, he and a couple of friends started a software company called Rain. Milo is head of product at Rain and continues to lead the company with his co-founders. He has competed in several bodybuilding competitions and is a judge for local NPC shows. For fun, Milo loves to make things and is currently trying to tackle high hydration sourdough bread. Milo LeBaron. Next is Elizabeth Olson. She is a host, mental health advocate, podcaster, choral singer, content creator, quilter, wife and mother of four boys, the CEO of Rock Your Mom Jeans. Elizabeth produces events focused on women's mental health. Normalizing hard conversations, she has helped dozens of women recognize their down days as a temporary part of their cycle. Elizabeth has shown empathy while proving that life can be happy without toxic positivity. She has thrown dance party retreats, weekend retreats, and has an international podcast. She also leads accountability and mastermind groups, helping women set and reach their goals. She enjoys flower arranging, boating, and traveling with her husband, Eric. Elizabeth Olson. Finally, we have Mindy Sumption. She was crowned Mrs. Arkansas USA 93-94 and has enjoyed judging pageants and coaching dozens of contestants. Mindy has a bachelor's degree from Brigham Young University. Following her passion for health, Mindy is a certified coach with Optavia, an aerobics instructor, a yoga instructor, and is a certified life coach with a library of meditations entitled Meditations with Mindy. She is the event director and producer of Date Night Yoga and is currently working as human relations director with Sumption Business Law. She and her husband, Steve, have been married for 40 years. They have seven amazing children and 15 incredible grandchildren. That is Mindy Sumption. Thank you so much for all your time and commitment to our organization, judges. We really appreciate you. Thank you.
All right. We want to take this time now to tell you about the official philanthropic organization of Mrs. America, the Victoria's Voice Foundation. David and Jackie Siegel lost their daughter, Victoria, to a drug overdose at just 18 years old. Through their tragedy, the Siegels have devoted themselves to reducing drug experimentation, addiction, and overdose death. Each of our contestants have created a costume that captures the essence of Utah. You'll have a chance to vote for your favorite by visiting MrsUtahAmerica.com and voting with your dollars. Your donation to our site to our state costume competition will directly benefit the Victoria Siegel Foundation and their ongoing fight to end the opioid epidemic. So, let's see their state costumes.
Hello. Eagle Mountain is known for its petroglyphs and as a stop on the Pony Express. It is also home to hawks, falcons, and eagles. I am Miss Eagle Mountain.
I'm Ms. Stewart, and I represent all the hardworking men and women of Utah. I am the American flag.
Miss Lehigh, representing one of Lehigh's most beautiful museums, I am Thanksgiving Point Butterfly Biosphere.
I am your Miss Linden, Utah, and I represent the hard work and the beautiful people of Utah. I am the honeybee.
Janice Peterson, Miss Price, I represent war and all the angels around us.
Amanda Holt, Miss Salt Lake City, representing my organ donor, the man that saved my life, Eric Ellsworth, 395. I am Utah Highway Patrol.
Miss Saratoga Springs, even though you can't tell it by the name, Utah State Bird is the California Gull.
Utah is home to many professional sports teams like Major League Soccer, Real Salt Lake, and their fans, Miss South Jordan.
Mrs. American Fork, representing higher education in Utah.
Mrs. Brigham City, I proudly represent the Golden Spike National Monument and the world's largest migratory bird refuge, both by Brigham City.
Home to four dark sky sanctuaries, I am Utah's National Parks Starry Night Sky.
Representing the delicious dairy industry of Utah, I am Miss Cache Valley Cowgirl. Boo!
Mrs. Mapleton, representing the six generations of jewelers that have helped 50,000 couples in Utah say yes. I am Rasmussen Jewelers.
Utah is home to the largest body of salt water in the Western Hemisphere. It is also has over 72 ionic trace minerals in it, and it is a crucial piece to the Utah economy. I am the Great Salt Lake and Mrs. Harriman.
Spicing up your life and Utah's life since 1918, I am the Morton Salt Girl, Mrs. Sandy City.
Mrs. Lehigh, representing Utah's astronauts and the world's largest rocket industry.
Assisting armed forces and teaching life-saving skills, I'm Mrs. Saratoga Springs, representing the American Red Cross, Utah chapter.
I am Mrs. Rocky Mountain. From our Rocky Mountains great to our dazzling lakes, I share the same golden birthstone too, from the only state that begins with you. I am the Topaz State.
This is Southern Utah County, here supporting Utah's local farmers.
My gown was designed by my sister and sewed by my mother-in-law, representing the Great Salt Lake and the contrast color of the lake.
Long before Park City became a world-class resort and host of the 2002 Winter Olympic Games, it was famous for the silver mining industry. My costume represents the historic silver mining industry of Utah. I am Melissa Hagen, this is Summit County.
I'm Mrs. Salt Lake County, here to tell you to take a hike, Utah, and wear sunscreen.
I'm Karen Kahn, Mrs. Davis County, paying tribute to my home state, my state I was born in, California, and my new cherished home of Utah. I am a seagull.
Mrs. Stampede County, representing the house that she built, the first house built in the nation entirely and solely by women, done right here in Utah.
Take a hike, building strength and unity through Utah's great outdoors. I am your Mrs. Utah Valley, representing Delicate Arch.
Utah's largest Independence Day celebration, designed to honor traditional American values of family, freedom, God, and country, I am Utah's Stadium of Fire and your Mrs. South Jordan.
From the mountains to the valleys, I've got you covered. I'm Utah's finest feature, the greatest snow on earth, and your Mrs. Spanish Fork.
Over 100,000 visitors flock to see the annual Tulip Festival. Representing Ashton Gardens at Thanksgiving Point, I am Clarissa Thomas, Mrs. Utah County.
Capitol Theater, Hale Center Theater, Desert Star, I am Utah's Performing Arts in Theater!
What do you think? Should we see them one more time? Let's see them all one more time. Have a brief intermission to allow you to cast your vote for your favorite state costume. Each vote costs $1, so visit www.mrsutahamerica.com to select your contestant, the number of votes you wish to cast, and then pay via credit card. You can also scan the QR codes that are located in the lobby. So go vote, and we'll see you soon.
Every single day of our lives, we are so lucky to have a choice. We have the choice to decide how we expend each hour, how we fill each minute of every day. We can choose to create, improve, learn, build, repair, connect, encourage, share, advocate, and make a difference from our own little corners of the world. As women of all ages in Utah, single, married, divorced, or widowed, we are now also very lucky to have a program which allows us to bring all of our knowledge, education, talents, and skills to a stage that gives us a powerful voice. I'm so grateful for being given the opportunity of a lifetime to represent our amazing state of Utah as Miss Utah for America Strong 2021. This pageant title instantly opened national and international doors and gave me a powerful voice for three main causes which I am very passionate about. Number one, the state-by-state legislative reform of the family court systems, child custody processes, and children's rights after parental separation or divorce. This year, because of my title, I was able to write legislative reform drafts and proposals which have come to the table this year or will be proposed in 2023 in at least 16 states across the country, which are aimed at protecting children's rights and reforming the family court systems. Cause number two, the Ilavash Initiative and Project Light Up Haiti. My most well-known cousin on my father's side of the family was Diana, Princess of Wales, who said it best, "Anywhere there is suffering, that is where I want to be, doing what I can." Being Miss Utah for America Strong also opened the doors for me to become a spokesperson for the massive Ilavash Initiative. We are creating sustainable communities for the entire Haitian island of Ilavash and the southern region of mainland Haiti. Our initiative is elevating long-term living conditions, healthcare, job creation, infrastructure and sanitation, educational opportunities, and the overall economy for both populations. Cause number three, COVID prevention and natural immunization boosting. I've been nicknamed the COVID queen due to contracting severe long COVID three times and because of my body's negative response to the vaccine. After being successfully treated by Dr. Vladimir Zev Zelenko, the medical scientist and physician who successfully treated President Trump and First Lady Melania, I am now an international spokesperson for natural forms of boosting the immune system to expedite the recovery process or to prevent illness. It has certainly been an unforgettable and momentous year, but I could not have done it without an army of fellow advocates. Thank you to all of my family, friends, pageant directors, and generous sponsors who've supported me this year. Because of you, we've been able to turn some of life's most difficult challenges into opportunities to improve the world around us. Thank you so very much to Diane Ritter, Jennifer Hunsicker, and Alicia Staggs. You are the most amazing, tirelessly supportive, empowering directors who've created an incomparable program in sisterhood. I'm so grateful for your strength and fire and belief in the power of women's voices. Ann Forrester, Hannah Nieleman, Maggie Mitchell, Paris Morris, Rochelle Moore, and all of our Utah America Sash sisters, I'm so honored that I had the chance to share this year's exciting journey with all of you. You are beautiful beacons of light, and I'm so blessed to be your friend and sister. Nicole West, you're more than a makeup artist. You're a sister to me. Thank you so much for everything. To my beautiful sisters, brother, and their families, and especially my wonderful mom and dad, I love you dearly, and I'm eternally grateful for you and your endless support. Finally, my beautiful sons, Logan and Kainua, you are my inspiration for wanting to make the world a better place. I'm so proud of you and what you are both achieving at BYU and Princeton University. I love you to infinity and beyond. And to Scott Norda, you're not only the man of my dreams, but also the kind of man that my daddy always prayed would come into my life. I'm so blessed that you'll be the one to change my title from Miss to Mrs. in just a few months. Thank you again to everyone. With love, Adrienne Edwards, Miss Utah for America Strong 2021.
It was an honor and a privilege to represent my home state as Mrs. Utah in 2021. I lived every day of this past year sharing the importance of my platform. Know your farmer, know your food. I am a rancher and a foodie, so together I'm a person who wants to know the composition and origin of their food, and it better taste good. Social media and technology has allowed me to share my message with millions across the globe and encourage others to connect and acquaint themselves with farmers and ranchers across the country to buy food from producers they know and trust. There is something so satisfying to eat food straight from a farm you are acquainted with. I'm grateful for the choices and options we have to sustain ourselves and families. I'm grateful for those who produce our food, which is a humbling, difficult, and never-ending task. The mantle is great. What a memorable time it was this past year representing Utah at the Mrs. America pageant. I was even blessed to be pregnant with my seventh child on the stage in Las Vegas. She got the whole thing figured out. It's me where it hurts, and I know I might be swinging at the curve. I don't mind it though, when the lights are low, she can hit the door. To this year's contestants, I say congratulations. It takes courage and resiliency to get on this stage and put yourself out there. You are all queens tonight. To our new royalty for this year, I applaud your hard work and dedication to being your best self. I know the types of sacrifices you had to make to put yourself in a position to win. You have my utmost respect and admiration. As a woman, wife, and mother, I am ready for my next adventure and eager to see what new heights this year's title holders achieve. The crown is being passed to the next worthy recipient, as it should be, to our next Mrs. Utah. May God be with us all in peace and tranquility is my prayer. Thank you for everything, Utah. Signing off.
Welcome back. AKA, take your seats. Da-na-na. Do we have the Jeopardy music queued up for people not in their seats yet? I'm just kidding. Real quick, before we move on, I would like to welcome Diane Ritter and Alicia Staggs for a very special announcement.
Hi, everybody. How are you? Come on. So, I'm going to tell you a story. It's not a long one. I'm not very good at it. But what you need to know is that it has been my privilege to be part of the Mrs. America organization for 27 years. I have been the director and co-director of the states of Arizona, Utah, and Texas. And the one thing that keeps me coming back, the one thing that I can assure you of, the why we do all of this, is because we are committed to being a community of women, supporting women in whatever their goals and their dreams are. And we know that you feel the same way. So 11 years ago, 3 weeks before the pageant, I got a phone call from a wonderful woman named Jennifer Hunziker. Did she have time to enter the pageant? Look at her. Of course. It was a fabulous year that started a friendship that has gone on for 11 years. She was a contestant. She worked with me by my side as my assistant in producing the pageant, and she also became the co-director of the pageant. She is my friend. She is my sister. She is truly one of the biggest blessings in my life. It's a little bittersweet this evening because I'm here to announce that this is Jennifer's curtain call. She's not going away 100%. She's stepping back a little bit to focus on other things and other priorities. So with that being said, stepping into her shoes is a phenomenal woman, Alicia Staggs, Mrs. Utah 2019. And the growth of the organization, everything that we've come to know, that you've come to know and experience through the Mrs. Utah America pageants, now we're American and also Miss, we will continue to grow with the partnership of the three of us, with Jen stepping back a little bit. She is my friend, as I said, my sister. I can't say I'm gonna miss her because I'm not gonna let her go very far, but she has been the cornerstone that pivoted us into renewed success. So with that, I say thank you. I love you. And if I say anything else, I'm gonna cry. So I just would love for you all to A, thank Jennifer with your applause, and welcome Alicia as my new co-director, and we're looking forward to a very bright future. So.
Take your flower.
Get a picture.
Jennifer Hunsicker, everybody.
All right, I told myself I wouldn't cry. Traditionally, the evening gown competition has been the most beautiful part of the show and counts for the final 25% of each contestant's score. Please join us in welcoming our Ms. Utah for America contestants, starting with Ms. Eagle Mountain, Leandrina Hadlock.
Someday, when I'm awfully low, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you in the way.
Thank you, Miss Eagle Mountain.
Tonight.
Ms. Jewab, Twyla Simpson.
Yes, you're lovely. With your smile so warm and your cheeks so soft, there is nothing for me but to love you and the way you look tonight.
Thank you, Miss Jewab.
With each word.
Ms. Lehigh, Natalie Castro.
Tearing my fear apart. And that laugh wrinkles your nose, touches my foolish heart. Lovely. Never, never change.
Thank you, Ms. Lehigh.
That breathless charm.
Ms. Linden, Tammy
Won't
Lewis.
Won't you please arrange it? 'Cause I love you just the way you look tonight.
Thank you, Miss Linden. Miss Price, Janice Peterson.
It touches my foolish heart. Lovely, don't you ever change. Keep that breathless charm. Won't you please arrange it? 'Cause I just the way you look tonight.
Thank you, Miss Price. Ms. Salt Lake City, Amanda Holt.
Just the way you look to night. Tell me when.
Thank you, Ms. Salt Lake City. Ms. Saratoga Springs, Rachel Mahoney.
We can share a love divine. Please don't make me wait again. When will you say?
Thank you, Ms. Saratoga Springs.
Tell me quando, quando.
Ms. South Jordan, Ashley Condi.
Tell me quando, quando, quando.
You mean happiness to me.
You mean happiness to me.
Oh, my love, please tell me when. Oh. Every moment.
Thank you, Miss South Jordan.
Let me show you the way.
Let me show you the way to a joy.
Let's bring our Miss Utah for America contestants back for a final look.
I can't wait a moment more.
Here is the part you've all been waiting for. Your first on-stage question. I'm going to read the question twice, and then I'll give you all a chance to answer. Okay? You guys want to know the question? It has nothing to do with ice cream, I promise. So, what do you hope to accomplish with as Miss Utah for America Strong? And I'll say it again. What do you hope to accomplish as Miss Utah for America Strong?
I joined the pageant as a healing step to help me find my voice after some traumatic experiences. After hearing the speeches from the queens and the pageant directors, they were super inspiring, and one of the things I'd like to do with the platform is inspire other people to be happy and to be positive and to move forward in life, because we all need the positive. Thank you.
Ms. Eagle Mountain, Leandria Headlock. All right, I'll repeat it again. What do you hope to accomplish as Ms. Utah, America Strong?
I joined the pageant because my mom actually made me, but I came on stage and I was like, whoa, what am I doing? And then I was like, okay. And then if I do win Miss Utah, I want to come out and help all of Utah and help others. Thank you.
Ms. Juab Twyla Simpson. What do you hope to accomplish as Miss Utah, America Strong?
As your Miss Utah for America Strong 2022, I am dedicated to creating an autism-friendly community through advocacy and teaching our community professionals how to better engage with individuals with autism, inspired by my sister, Angie.
Ms. Lehigh, Natalie Castro. What do you hope to accomplish as Miss Utah for America Strong?
Well, it takes one to know one. I live with my disabilities every day. I help my son with his challenges every day. And I'm committed to bringing change and understanding to those in our communities.
Ms. Lyndon Tammy Lewis. What do you hope to accomplish as Ms. Utah for America Strong?
As Ms. Utah 2022, I want everyone to live their lives to the fullest. Because one moment, you can have it all, and the next minute, it can be gone. And that takes courage to rise back on your feet again. So know that there is resources and there is help out there.
Ms. Price, Janice Peterson. What do you hope to accomplish as Ms. Utah for America Strong?
I am alive today because my organ donor decided to become an organ donor. And with that being said, I want to increase the number by 10,000 this year of organ donation. Thank you.
Ms. Salt Lake City, Amanda Holt. What do you hope to accomplish as Ms. Utah for America Strong?
As a single parent for 12 years, I know firsthand the struggles they face. I've had to dig for quarters from my car and my couches so I could buy me and my daughter top ramen to feed us for a week because we made too much money for state assistance but not enough to survive. As Miss Utah for America Strong, I will spend my time advocating for single parents, bringing awareness to the different struggles they face, financial or social. I will build a community with the Single Parent Project and spend my time providing free resources to single parents in our area. Thank you.
Miss Saratoga Springs, Rachel Mahoney. What do you hope to accomplish as Miss Utah for America Strong?
I'd like to be Miss Utah so I can strengthen even more girls and women to live their strongest, healthiest lives through physical and emotional wellness.
Miss South Jordan, Ashley Condi. Thank you, ladies. And now, for the evening gown competition for our Mrs. Utah contestants, beginning with Mrs. American Fork, Brooklyn Wild. Thank you, Mrs. American Fork. Mrs. Brigham City, Jamie Hatfield. Thank you, Mrs. Brigham City. Mrs. Cache Valley, Chelsea Roberts.
Say it's me that you adore. And then, darling, tell me.
Thank you, Mrs. Cache Valley.
And then, darling,
Mrs. Davis County, Karen Kahn.
Oh, my darling, tell me
thank you, Mrs. Davis County.
Moonlight becomes you.
Mrs. Draper,
it
Lauren Anderson.
With your hair, you certainly know the right thing to wear. Moonlight becomes you. I'm thrilled at the sight, and I could get so romantic. You're all dressed up to go dreaming.
Thank you, Mrs. Draper.
Tell me I'm wrong.
Mrs. Harriman, Amanda Brady.
Night to go dreaming.
mind if I tag along? If I say I love you, I want you to know it's not just because there's moonlight, although moonlight becomes your soul.
Thank you, Mrs. Harriman. Mrs. Lehigh Michelle Miles.
You're all dressed up to go dreaming. Now don't you tell me I'm wrong. What a night to go dreaming. Mind if I tag along? If I say I love you, I want you to know it's not just because there's moonlight. Although,
thank you, Mrs. Lehigh. Mrs. Mapleton, Kaylee Fawcett.
Moonlight becomes your soul.
Heaven, I'm in heaven. My heart beats so that I can.
Thank you, Mrs. Mapleton. Mrs. Rocky Mountain, Jessica Whalen.
When we're out together, dancing cheek to cheek. Yes, heaven. I'm in heaven. I'm around me through the week seems to vanish like a gambler's like.
Thank you, Mrs. Rocky Mountain.
When we out together,
Mrs. Salt Lake City, Andrea Schmutz.
Oh, I'd love to climb to mountain, reach the highest peak. But it doesn't thrill me half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I'd love to go out fishing in a river or a creek. But I don't enjoy it half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Now, mama, dance with me. I want my arms.
Thank you, Mrs. Salt Lake City. Mrs. Salt Lake County, Faith Solom.
Yes, heaven. I'm in heaven. And my heart beats so that I can hardly speak. And I seem to find the happiness I seek. When we out together, dance cheek to cheek. Take it, Ella, swing it.
Heaven, I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak.
Thank you, Mrs. Salt Lake County. Mrs. Sandy City, Heidi Peterson.
When we're out together, dancing cheek to cheek. Heaven, I'm in heaven, and the cares that hung.
Thank you, Mrs. Sandy City. Mrs. San Pete County, Jennifer Crozier.
But it doesn't thrill me half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I love to go out fishing in a river or a creek, but I don't enjoy it half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Come on and dance with me. I want my arms.
Thank you, Mrs. Sanpete County. Mrs. Saratoga Springs, Mandy Turner.
Will carry me through to heaven. I'm in heaven. And my heart beats so that I can hardly speak. And I seem to find the happiness I seek.
Thank you, Mrs. Saratoga Springs. Mrs. South Jordan, Laura Forbush. Thank you, Mrs. South Jordan. Mrs. Southern Utah County, Haley Lundberg.
I've got you under my skin. So deep in my heart that you're really a part.
Thank you, Mrs. Southern Utah County.
I've
Mrs. Spanish Fork, Ashley Stratton.
Under my skin. I tried so not to give in. I said to myself, this affair never will go so well. But why should I try to resist when, baby, I know so well I've got you.
Thank you, Mrs. Spanish
under
Fork.
My skin.
Mrs. Summit County,
I'd
Melissa Hagen.
I'd sacrifice anything come what might for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. But each time that I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. 'Cause I've got you.
Thank you, Mrs. Summit County. Mrs. Utah County, Clarissa Thomas. Thank you, Mrs. Utah County. Mrs. Utah Valley, Micah Perry.
I would sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near. In spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats how it yells in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Why not use your mentality? Step up, wake up to reality. But each time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop just before I begin. 'Cause I've got you under my skin.
Thank you, Mrs. Utah Valley.
Yes, I've got you.
Mrs. West Jordan, Kimberly Matichard.
Every time it rains, pennies from heaven. Don't you know each cloud contains pennies from heaven? You'll find your fortune falling all over the town. Be sure that your umbrella.
Thank you, Mrs. West Jordan.
Upside down. Trade them for a package of sunshine and flowers.
Let's bring our Mrs. Utah contestants back for a final look.
You love, you must have showers. So when you hear it thunder, don't run under a tree. There'll be pennies from heaven for you and me.
Thank you, ladies. Thank you, ladies.
You must have showers. So when you hear thunder, don't run under a tree. There'll be pennies from heaven for you and me.
Thank you, ladies.
Every time you are near.
Thank you, ladies.
They long to be close to you. Why do stars fall down from the sky every time you walk by? Just like me.
Now, let's bring back our Miss Utah for America Strong contestants. Ladies.
On the day that you were born, the angels got together and decided to create a dream come true. So they sprinkled moon dust in your hair of gold and starlight in your eyes of blue. That is why.
It is time Now to narrow our field from 8 to 3. The three finalists for Ms. Utah for America Strong, in no particular order, are... Like I said, no particular order. The top three, Ms. Lehigh, Natalie Castro. Ms. Eagle Mountain, Leandria Hadlock. And Ms. Saratoga Springs, Rachel Mahoney. Thank you, ladies. Another round of applause for all the Ms. Utah for America Strong contestants.
Adrian.
How's everyone doing out there tonight? Yeah, it's tonight. It counts.
Hey, so let's bring our top three back.
Yeah. Hey, top three. Ms. America, Utah Strong, get out of here. You, three. Yeah. I know you tried to dodge another question, but it's not happening, okay? Ladies, you're each going to be asked one final question from this bowl. These questions are taken from last year's contestants' biographies. You're each going to choose a question, hand it to me. I'm going to read it twice, and then you're going to have 15 seconds or less to answer. Yeah, let's do it. Choose wisely. All right. What is your experience representing an organization, and what was the outcome? I'll read it again. What is your experience representing an organization, and what was the outcome?
I was lucky enough to speak to Riverton High School on behalf of the Single Parent Project, and I told my story about the things I've struggled with through my single parent journey and how we can build a community and overcome them for all single parents. The outcome was a silent auditorium of high school teenagers, so that's pretty rare, and a lot of crying by everybody. Thank you.
Ms. Saratoga Springs. Oh. All right. What do you feel is the biggest challenge facing our youth, and how will you help solve it? I'll read it again. What do you feel is the biggest challenge facing our youth, and how will you help to solve it?
Accepting your uniqueness and being completely you and authentically you and living within your passion.
Ms. Lehigh. Don't be nervous. It's okay. All right. If you could give your younger self one piece of advice, what would it be? I'll read it again. If you could give your younger self one piece of advice, what would it be?
I would tell myself to believe in myself, because everything that I have gone through that has been hard for me, I've been able to get through just fine. And so I would tell myself not to worry and to be more positive and try to get through it in a better way, with a better attitude, rather than letting it depress me. Thank you.
Ms. Eagle Mountain. Thank you, ladies. The next time we'll see them, we'll be announcing our next Ms. Utah for America Strong 2022. But first, it's time to narrow our field of Mrs. Utah contestants. Let's bring all of the contestants back onto the stage. Just like me, we long to be. Are the votes in for our top 10? All right. How's everyone doing on stage tonight? Yeah? Are you guys ready for the breakdance portion in the evening gown? It's a new requirement. Sorry, we just got the update. Yeah. Where are my past queens? Are they available? Let's chat with them for a little bit. Come on out. Let's give it up for Hannah Nealman. So while we wait, what has it been like the last year wearing the crown?
Well, in the short answer, it gives me headaches, so I haven't worn it very often. No, but this year has opened so many doors for myself and our family, and the message that we share with ultimately the world. And I've been so grateful for that, to see this program and technology and social media really make a difference and educating people about directing their food sources from farmers and ranchers they know and trust, because that's what we do as a family. And it has been an opportunity that has opened many doors. So I'm forever grateful.
Nice. Your 2021 Mrs. Utah, Hannah Nealman. Now, your turn. Okay. Mrs. Utah, Mayor Cahan, what has it been like wearing the crown?
Having a sash and a crown really is a microphone. I've been able to go into schools and classrooms and share my literacy platform, which is near and dear to my heart. And with a sash and a crown, your position is elevated and you're able to spread your message to so many more people. And for that, I have been so grateful. And it has been an amazing year. Going to nationals and competing at America Week has been a highlight of this year. So I'm excited to see who will get that next opportunity.
Thank you. Your 2021 Miss American, Ann Forrester. I think we, do we have our top 10? Okay. What about the... All right. The top 10 contestants in no particular order. Mrs. Brigham City, Jamie Hadfield. Mrs. Harriman, Amanda Brady. Mrs. Mapleton, Kaylee Fawcett. Mrs. Rocky Mountain, Jessica Whalen. Mrs. Salt Lake City, Andrea Schmutz. Mrs. Sandy City, Heidi Peterson. Mrs. Saratoga Springs, Mandy Turner. Mrs. South Jordan, Laura Forbush. Mrs. Utah County, Clarissa Thomas. And Mrs. Utah Valley, Micah Perry. Thank you, ladies. You are all amazing. All right, ladies, now we will give our judges a chance to hear from our semifinalists. Ladies, in 15 seconds or less, what is the one thing you hope to accomplish with the crown?
I plan to promote unity in families, couples, and individuals. 65% of Utah is set apart for recreational use. Research shows that those who are connected with nature feel their lives are more worthwhile. I have reached out to several national and state park agencies, and they are excited to work with me as your next Mrs. Utah America. Thank you.
Mrs. Utah Valley. I'll read the question again. What is one thing you hope to accomplish with the crown?
I am determined to educate and empower on women's health, that we may be advocates for our own bodies on our individual health journeys, just like my journey that I've had with PMDD, premenstrual dysphoric disorder.
Miss Utah County. I'll read the question one more time. What is the one thing you hope to accomplish with the crown?
As Mrs. Utah, I plan to continue to focus on this mental health pandemic that we are all dealing with. I will continue my work with Wolf Pact, which is a nonprofit organization, which is a program for teen suicide awareness prevention, and I will continue rolling out Utah House Bill 162, known as the Utah Period Project.
Mrs. Saratoga Springs. All right, I'll read it again. What is the one thing you hope to accomplish with the crown?
As Mrs. Utah America, I will continue my work with building strength through diversity by connecting people through conversation. Thank you.
Mrs. Sandy City. What is the one thing you hope to accomplish with the crown?
The value of Mrs. Utah America are to live and strengthen one another to accomplish individual goals for the betterment state of Utah. I would like to inspire and be an influence for good to women and girls across the nation. To these women, I want to say that your outer appearance is not all that defines beauty. Gaining a formal education will not only benefit you by giving you the confidence that you need, but will make you an asset to your community and to the world. Lastly, I want to tell the world, as an Asian immigrant woman, that I'm confidently beautiful, kind, and smart.
Mrs. Salt Lake City. What is the one thing you hope to accomplish with the crown?
I'm dedicated to my personal platform, which is Impoverished to Improved. I advocate with United Way and the Salvation Army, and I educate the individuals how to get out of poverty. In Utah, 10% of the population are impoverished, and that number is risen when you are a single parent and when you are a minority. That is 44%. As Mrs. Utah, I'm here to lessen that number, and this can only be made possible through the Mrs. America organization.
Ms. Rocky Mountain. What is the one thing you hope to accomplish with the crown?
As Mrs. Utah, we are going to grow the global Be the Good community. We're going to do this through the Be the Good podcast and through the weekly Be the Good challenge. And as Mrs. Utah, that's my commitment to continue to serve each and every day.
Mrs. Harriman. What is the one thing you hope to accomplish with the crown?
I am on a mission to keep our kids off the drug path. I've done this for 15 years across our state, speaking to thousands of students in our state, helping them understand, though, a different perspective of the drug epidemic. Yes, drugs hurt our bodies, but when we buy drugs, we are hurting other innocent people. Our teens are so socially minded. I learned this as a high school teacher and college professor. When they realize that their choices do hurt other people, they are less likely to go down the drug path, and that is my goal as a Mrs. Utah America.
Mrs. Brigham City. What is the one thing you hope to accomplish with the crown?
I believe that true connection and true healing comes from telling your story. And when one person is brave enough to tell their true story, other people find their own bravery. So I am going to help people tell their story.
Mrs. Mapleton, what is the one thing you hope to accomplish with the crown?
My platform is Strive to Thrive, and it's about empowering children to thrive in the face of adversity. And as your next Mrs. Utah, I would continue to work with both local and national organizations to make sure that our children have the tools and the resources that they need to be successful. Thank you.
Mrs. South Jordan. Thank you, ladies. I don't envy the judges one bit. Thank you. An event like this is not possible without a host of people behind the scenes. Thank you to our photographers, Liam Wynn and Whitney Lambert. Thank you to our staff, Peyton Ashby, Christy Bauer, Whitney Lambert, Rachel Moore, and Jessica Steeling. Thank you to Mrs. Utah 2019 Ashley Staggs for choreographing and directing tonight's show. Thank you to our auditors, Diane Ritter, and Mrs. Utah 2001 Tammy Wyatt. Thank you to our sponsors, Graham Swim, for the incredible swimsuits you saw tonight. Be sure to visit them at grahamswim.com for all your swimwear needs. Wright Flower Company in Springville for the beautiful bouquets we will award to our title holders. I saw them. They're gorgeous. Another thank you to Ibsen Dress Boutique, Eslo Brow and Hair Salon, Michael Scott Photography, Katie Livingston, Ellis Printing, Dry Bar, Osmond Designs, Elite Academy, Whimsy Clothing Tuscan, The Comfort Suites and Convention Center in Ogden. Did I say Tucson? That's what I meant to say. 22nd Avenue Entertainment Logistics. It takes a village to create an event of this magnitude, and we are very grateful for ours. Now, you're in for a very special treat. Performing a traditional Hawaiian dance, your Ms. Utah for America Strong 2021, Adrian Edwards. Was amazing. It is now time to narrow our Mrs. Utah contestants from 10 to 5. Let's bring back our semi-finalists. Don't they look stunning? I know, there they come. Our top five yet? No? That's great.
Your smile so
Adrian, I want to talk to you about that awesome
and
dance.
Your
Where'd you go?
So soft.
Just kidding, she's changing. Let's get our queens back out here. Where are they at? Are they changing too? Yeah. Oh, there they are. Whoa. Right there, that's fine. So, I'm gonna ask a very important question. All right, a lot of people know what it is already. What's your favorite ice cream? Hard-hitting questions here at the pageant today, folks.
I really enjoy Rocky Road because you get a little bit of everything, and that's my personality.
Fantastic. All right, same question. What's your favorite ice cream?
So I actually have my own milk cow, and I cream the cream off that milk, and I make homemade ice cream. Doesn't matter the flavor, but it's always the best.
No wonder you're the queen. That's all I'm saying. Yeah. So what is your hope for the winner who takes the crown for 2022?
I'm just so excited. Everyone keeps asking if I'm getting emotional, but I'm so excited for the next woman that takes the crown because it is a year full of opportunities and joys and experiences that are once in a lifetime. So I'm very excited.
Now, to add to that, what can the winner of Miss American, what can they look forward to as their reign in 2022?
Your year will go by so quickly, and so make the most of it. Take every opportunity to reach out and do community service, meet those in our community, leaders. I was able to visit schools and classrooms, and it's just an amazing opportunity to represent Utah and to be a leader. And represent Utah on a national stage is an amazing opportunity. And so I'm really excited for whoever I get to crown will get to have that opportunity. And just being a light for married women in Utah. All of you have amazing platforms. And so it is just so incredible to see you being that light and shining so bright. And I'm just thrilled for all of our finalists.
Okay, I'm not gonna cry. So let's give another round of applause for our semi-finalist, huh? Oh, I think you could do better than that. Let's give him a round of applause. All right, since we have some time to kill, it's my favorite part of the show. Give me one experience that you both had during your reign that really just sticks out in 2021.
America Week is a big part of the Mrs. America organization. And so we talk a lot about nationals because it's just an amazing experience to go to Las Vegas and represent your home state is unlike any other. And just being able to walk on the stage where Elvis once performed and other great performers, it is just, it's incredible. And I just am so excited.
Yeah. So the night that I won, we got in the car and the kids were so excited. And I said, kids, you milked the cow before we came, right? Because we have to milk twice a day. And they said, no, we still have to do it. And my mom was on the phone with me. She said, you better milk the cow in your crown so you can Instagram it. So we did. And a few days later, the Wall Street Journal called and she said, I saw you milking your cow in your crown. And we want to put you on the cover of the Wall Street Journal and share your message. And we did. And it was a really neat opportunity.
Nice. Yeah. I'm just saying, I envy all of you. I could not walk in those heels. No, I've tried it, trust me. Sorry again for running into you. Okay, so last question, maybe. Just kidding. All right, let's see. Wow, man, I had a good one. Well, thank you, queens. We'll see you later. Hey, thank you. All right, you guys ready for the top five? No, you're not. Are you ready for the top five? All right, the top five in no particular order. Mrs. Brigham City, Jamie Hadfield. Mrs. Harriman, Amanda Brady. Mrs. Rocky Mountain, Jessica Whalen. Mrs. Saratoga Springs, Mandy Turner. And Mrs. Utah County, Clarissa Thomas. Thank you, ladies. Let's give all of our semifinalists a big round of applause. Now, ladies, you're going to ask one final question from the magical bowl. And it's not about ice cream. Do we have the bowl? Yeah? Yeah. You guys come back. Here they come. Now, these questions are taken from last year's contestant biographies. You each will choose a question, hand it to me, read it twice, and you'll have 15 seconds to answer. Choose your question. Or your destiny. Come on, join me up front. It's my favorite part of the stage. When was the last time you felt like you made a difference in someone else's life? I'll read it again. When was the last time you felt like you made a difference in someone's life?
Just backstage, actually. Yesterday I had a conversation with one of the contestants about her health and what we can do to start her own personal health journey. And it's in every day you meet somebody where they are and you go from there. And for me, that is what I look forward to most, is to meet more people and educate them on their health.
Thank you. Thank you. This is Utah County. I feel like we should have a drum roll queued up. Come on. All right. What is one of the most serious problems in our society today? And what do you think is the best solution to that problem? I'll read it again. What is the most serious problem in our society today? And what do you think the best solution is to that problem?
I feel like our teens need to have the tools and the resources to be able to get through their struggles and their negative emotions and negative thoughts that they're having. And I feel like the importance of me wanting to try to get rid of this stigma that asking for help is a weakness.
Thank you. Mrs. Saratoga Springs, your turn. All right. What do you feel is the most important attribute of a title holder? What do you feel is the most important attribute of a title holder?
One who is dedicated. This is a job. It's 365 days a year. It's not just what happens on stage tonight. And I'm dedicated to make a difference here in the state of Utah. Being a diverse woman and growing up in a single parent household hasn't always been easy, but it's taught me hard work and the dedication. And through this, I can help propel the Mrs. Utah and Mrs. America organizations forward and get it into places that it hasn't been yet. I look forward to doing this as the next Mrs. Utah.
Thank you. Mrs. Rocky Mountain. All right. Oof, this is deep.
Oh boy.
If tomorrow were your last day on Earth, how would you spend it? If tomorrow were your last day on Earth, how would you spend it?
If there's one thing my age has taught me, and being a mom of five kids, is to enjoy the little things. So obviously I would spend it with my family, but quite frankly, we would be doing what makes us happy, which is service. which is why Be the Good is so important, and which is why, as Mrs. Utah, we're gonna grow the global Be the Good community, and it's gonna change things for the better.
Thank you, Mrs. Harriman. No peeking.
I thought there was just one left.
No. All right, final question.
Are you saying woodchuck? Yeah.
How has your Mrs. Utah journey changed you? I'll read it again. How has your Mrs. Utah journey changed you?
Oh, I just believe that pageant skills are life skills. Those of you who are doubters, give it a try. More than anything, what's changed me the most is that it gives me the platform to help us, to help save more kids. We are at an epidemic, at a crisis with our drug issues. The last 2 years, our teens got thrown into a tunnel. Their lives were shut down, and drug problems went up. I am so changed by this pageant, and I hope to change more lives as the next title holder, helping our teens understand a perspective that drug use also harms other people. That is the most effective way to get their attention, especially done by Queen and a Crown.
Thank you, Mrs. Brigham City. All right, let's give it up again for our top five. Thank you, ladies. These judges certainly have their work cut out for them. Let's give them another huge round of applause. Time you walk by, just like me, they long to be close to you. On the day that you were. Technical difficulties. All right. In just a few moments, we will have three new title holders. But first, will Adrian Edwards' family please come down to the stairs? The lights are so bright. For the last year, Adrian Edwards has been a shining light to everyone she meets. Her energy and genuine enthusiasm for life are remarkable. She is a passionate advocate for parental rights and is the living embodiment that the greatest joy can still come after the greatest pain. Ladies and gentlemen, your Ms. Utah for America Strong 2021, Adrian Edwards. Mrs. Utah American 2021. Ann Forrester knew the impact a child's literacy can have on their life. Over the last year, she has read to countless elementary age children and spoken with hundreds more as she has helped them understand how they can read today, lead tomorrow. Even though her reign will end tonight, her passion for her message will continue on. Ladies and gentlemen, your Mrs. Utah American 2021, Anne Forrester.
Birds on a wire, I'll fly away.
Can we have the family of Anne Forrester? Thank you, Anne. Can I get the family of Hannah Nealman to the stage, please? When Hannah Nealman and her husband Daniel bought a farm in Camas, they never dreamed that the road would lead them here tonight. During her time with the Crown, she has helped hundreds of thousands of people engage with the growers and ranchers who produce our nation's food supply. While she will continue to share her message on a daily basis, her natural ease, infectious smile, and generous spirit will be what we remember most about her reign. Ladies and gentlemen, your Mrs. Utah America 2021, Hannah Nealman.
She won't believe me, and it's so sad to think that she don't see what I see. But every time she asks me, do I look okay, I say, when I see your face.
Thank you, Hannah.
There's not a thing that I would change, 'cause you're
thank you, Adrian, and Hannah. You have done an exceptional job representing our state this year. Now please, welcome back to the stage all of our contestants. Have no bearing on the overall selection of Mrs. Utah 2022 or Ms. Utah for America 2022. Oh, here we go. All right, the fancy cards. The first awards were chosen by our contestants. These ladies have embodied the spirit of Mrs. Utah and Ms. Utah America, for America, as they have interacted with their sisters not just this weekend, but over the last several months. Our Mrs. Utah, Miss Congeniality, is Mrs. Sandy City, Heidi Peterson. Your Miss Utah for America Strong, Miss Congeniality is Miss Lehigh Natalie Castro. The next award was chosen by our judges, former title holders, and staff, and recognizes the women who just can't seem to take a bad picture. The photogenic award goes to Mrs. Salt Lake County, Faith Solem. We now have a very special award, the only award the directors have any influence over, the Director's Award. This woman embodies the spirit of Mrs. Utah and Ms. Utah for America. She goes out of her way to lift other women and create a community wherever she goes. The Mrs. Utah Director's Award goes to Mrs. Cache Valley, Chelsea Roberts. Don't fall. The Ms. Utah for America Strong Director's Award goes to Ms. Lyndon Tammy Lewis. Our next special award is given in memory of Mrs. Utah America 2000, Heather Hansen's daughter, Kennedy. Kennedy was well known for her smile as she fought juvenile Batten's disease, a rare degenerative disorder that took her life in 2014. Her legacy is her smile as portrayed in the movie Love, Kennedy. The Kennedy Hansen Most Beautiful Smile goes to Mrs. Draper, Lauren Anderson. And the results are in for the state costume contest. Thank you all. We raised a whopping $4,207 for the Victoria Siegel Foundation. However, I can't win. I appreciate that. But the winner of the state costume competition is Amanda Brady. Congratulations to all of our winners. Now, before we go any further, I've been given another note. Can I have Jen Hunsinger, Alicia Staggs, and Diane Ritter come to center stage, please? Yeah. You're in trouble.
So these three amazing women have touched so many women's lives, including mine, as I ran in two different pageants, and all these women on stage and all the staff. Each one of us have competed with one of these ladies being our director. And we are so proud to have them be a part of our family and that we wanted to tell them thank you for all that you've done. And I want to let you guys know, anyone out there, look at these amazing women that are back here on stage. If you want to do this next year, do it. These women owned who they were on the stage, all body types. And then you get to work with these amazing women and maybe us. But these guys are amazing. And we're super sad that Jen is leaving. I mean, not really leaving, but, you know, I don't know what you're really doing. But But Alicia is going to be amazing. And I just am so grateful for these women who have come into my life and have helped my self-esteem and helped me progress in my life. And we just want to tell them thank you. You can go give it to them. And we also, the Miss, also have flowers for them also.
That was my line.
Yeah, it's always
all right. Are you guys ready for the first crowning moment of the night? Fantastic. Will our Ms. Utah for America Strong top three please step forward? All right. Our second runner-up is Miss Saratoga Springs, Rachel Mahoney. Now, before we announce the first runner-up, let me remind you that the role of the first runner-up is very important. Should for any reason Ms. Utah for America Strong is unable to fulfill her obligation, the first runner-up will assume title and position. The first runner-up is Ms. Lehigh, Natalie Castro. And our 2022 Ms. Utah for America Strong is Ms. Eagle Mountain, Leandria Hadlock. Before we make our final announcement of the evening, though, I'd like to remind you that we have a little bit of official business we need to take care of with our official photographer after the pageant. So I ask you, please do not approach the stage until you're told to do so. Will all of our Mrs. Utah finalists please step forward? The third runner-up is, what? JK. Ah. It's different on here, and yeah, we got it. Is it this one? Because on here, it's, yeah.
Hang on, hang on.
Hold. Just kidding.
So,
see?
10, 11,
that's what 12. I was doing.
Okay, good.
Man. Good thing I talk words good. So based off the numbers, the third runner up, am I going the other one first?
No, you're doing yours right.
See, I'm getting the death eyes from Diane though.
He's fine.
Okay. Well, good thing my will's filled out. The third runner-up is Mrs. Saratoga Springs, Mandy Turner. The second runner-up is Mrs. Utah County, Clarissa Thomas. Now, on to our first Mrs. Utah crowning moment of the night. In 2022, the Miss America organization felt it was important to honor not one, but two married women from each state on the national stage. Mrs. Utah American will not only serve the state of Utah, but she will go on to compete in the Mrs. American competition later this year. Our Mrs. Utah American 2022 is Mrs. Harriman Amanda Brady. Our first runner-up. Let me remind you again that the role of the first runner-up is very important. Should either Mrs. Utah American or Mrs. Utah America be able to unable to complete their obligation for any reason, our first runner-up will assume their title. Our first runner-up is Mrs. Brigham City, Jamie Hadfield. And our 2022 Mrs. Utah America is Mrs. Rocky Mountain, Jessica Whalen. Give another round of applause for our Miss America, for America Strong, Mrs. Utah American, and Mrs. Utah America. Thank you all very much for coming. Please drive safely, and a quick reminder to all the families, please do not come up on stage until we clear you. These beautiful ladies have worked very hard to get here, so please let them get the pics for the gram. We'll see you next year.
I lie and look up at you. When the morning comes, I watch you rise. There's a paradise they couldn't capture, that bright infinity inside your eyes.
매일 밤 내게 날아가, 꿈이란 것도 잊은 채 나 웃으며 너를 만나. Never ending forever, baby.
When I'm without you, I'm crazy. 자, 어서 내 손을 잡아. We are made.